We're missing a key piece of equipment. That's commonplace today. Catchers. We're taking the brunt of the pitchers. Fastballs right into the palm of their bare hands. Now we're talking about catchers who would catch the pitches on a hop simply because it wouldn't hurt as much. Glove wearing is seen as a sign of weakness. Even players nursing hand injuries are ridiculed for wearing gloves, and players refer to them as sissy mittens. Everyone else is like, I don't want anything to do with the glove. It's my masculinity. It's machoism. It was frowned upon. It was a sign of weakness. People would be like, who's this wimp?
Yeah, mom, aren't you?
Spalding knows that if he can create a glove, he might be able to save players' hands, allowing them to keep using his baseballs.
Where are you going?
Give me a pair of scissors.
Scissors. But he'll also have to convince players to wear them. So Spalding sets out to design a homemade glove of his own to wear during games.
Just a simple glove, like you would wear driving a car. It's not the glove that we see today on the field for tomorrow's game.
In 1877, Spalding steps out onto the field, donning his handmade glove.
He comes out there, and he owns it. He was someone that people looked up to.
She follows Perry. It's so funny.
Because he was so well respected.
Spalding's own celebrity in the game of baseball really helped him promote this. This was someone who was already a kind of trusted voice, saying, hey, I know how to make the game better. I'm already doing this.
It went from having this stigma where more and more players started wearing gloves.
Soon the idea of a baseball player wearing a glove
was respectable.
Yes, players all around the National League.
For their best player to stay on the field rather than sitting on the bench in a bandage.
With the increased interest in glove wearing, Spalding sees a new opportunity.
Being the great entrepreneur that he is, he decides to capitalize on this glove thing.
The brothers get to work improving AG's makeshift design.
Is she tapping your thumb?
They sew a dense pad and extra layer of leather into the palm.
I think we're nearly there.
Later, they'll extend the fingers to create more protection. Spalding now has a second product to sell to pro players.
She's coming down closer to you than she was to me.
Baseball glove, and when you call it a glove, don't think about what you see today.
With no webbing between the thumb and
they haven't had. They haven't had their millet in a couple days because it's been rainy, so they're probably like, wah!
Spalding's glove is a hit and takes baseball to a whole new level.
Come on, Tansy, there's your chance.
Spalding opens a brick and mortar store in Chicago and will eventually go on to open 13 more.
Now, every kid in America could buy a Spalding baseball, the same one.
When she goes so slow, like, oh, step, and then Barry's there.
Play the growing list of sports in America.
They move quickly from baseball to every sport imaginable. There's a Spalding manual on every sport. But the important thing for Spalding equipment.
Spalding's success in creating,
can you get her to spin?
The first official baseball, but establishing the use of gloves secures his place in baseball history. But as Spalding devotes more and more time to his growing business, he decides
he hold the food like it's your finger and then go around her head. Oh, she did it! She did it for Dad! Look at that!
Are you
Sports
crazy because not only has Spalding essentially created the modern sporting goods industry, but also the modern foundation.
Looking to create a ball for a new indoor game, he's just invented.
Perry's like, hey.
Quite not sure yet. You feel she's ready to bolt in
head. Mm-hmm.